Did you know that the first RBMK was not the one that we know, for example, from Chernobyl history? The RBMK 1000 was not actually the first design in this nuclear reactor family. However, the RBMK had been upgraded. Its successor, RBMK 1000, revealed many more flaws. Watch this episode until the end and learn how the USSR's major achievement was a really bad design. Hello guys! This is episode number 6 of our new mini-series about the RBMK reactor history and design. Let's just say you're eager to hear more about it, so we made additional episodes on this subject as we planned to make only 4 now. But then again, you have made it clear we have to prepare the next ones faster than we have planned. And that just makes us happy to know you're as interested in this as we are. The last times we told you about the first design, how did it come to life, what was the overall atmosphere in the USSR and around the world, what was the historical background, and what flaws were discovered during the first drafts of the RBMK design and after the first reactor was commissioned in Leningrad's power plant. This time, we continue the subject from episode number 5. We will tell you more about the change of the primary design from RBMK to RBMK 1000. However, the designers tried to make the RBMK work and be safe. They lacked technology and materials given the goal that was set by the Communistic Party. A cheap, easy to build, powerful reactor. This just didn't come together easily. RBMK Nuclear Reactor History, Part 6. Make it better, but cheaply and quickly. To give you better context if you haven't watched the previous episodes, the Ministry of Medium Machine Building, also called Sredmash, which name was just a cover for an off-grid agency taking care of every nuclear-related project, ordered a new type of reactor. This reactor had to be powerful and possible to be built with limited resources, including fuel, building materials, and technology. The first blueprints arrived and one design was particularly well received. It was the RBMK reactor. Its parts could be constructed in a heavy machinery factory producing tanks and tractors in Leningrad. This design, however best fitting the requirements of the ministry, had a lot of flaws that were discussed even before it was constructed. Few scientists warned about the dangers it carried, including the positive void coefficient that made the reactor susceptible to particular events that, in some cases, could make the reactor basically a small nuclear bomb as it was prone to explosion. When one scientist didn't agree with the ministry discarding his warnings, he began to write lots of letters addressed to many different people inside the scientific community and in the party. Finally, they reached the Central Committee of the Communist Party and the Soviet Council of Ministers, the highest political power in the USSR at the time. However, they were warned. The government decided that the centrally planned economy was more important than some possible dangers of the newly designed RBMK reactor. But they didn't ignore the warnings totally, as they assigned the designers of the new reactor to work on the overhaul of their blueprints. One of the main reasons was that despite the economy of the USSR, already under the huge weight of military spending, needing the new type of reactor, they couldn't afford to commission the uncertain new design that was under questioning by the scientific community even during the designing phase. Especially, the reactor was supposed to serve civilian needs. The modifications were hard to implement as they needed complex work, which meant the designers got behind the party requested schedule. Soviet computing technology was far behind the US and could be considered primitive at the time. This also meant that calculating the reactor properties, including the performance, was taking a lot of time and the results were often unreliable. The designers fought with both technology setbacks and the growing impatience of the politicians. Sredmash, like any other ministry, was dependent on political will, and failing to deliver the plans could mean bad things for the ministry and its employees. At the time, the USSR was already hugely corrupted, often because the centrally planned economy didn't include any stagnation or failures. Some people responsible for particular projects reported them done even knowing they weren't. Maybe the RBMK situation was a bit different, but similar nonetheless. To save time, Sredmash just skipped the prototype phase entirely. What did that mean? It meant that the tests had to happen on a living organism, so just putting them directly into production, commissioning them, and adjusting if needed. If this sounds dangerous and irresponsible to you, you're right. It was. The nuclear reactor isn't a thing that could be field tested without proper preparations before. But it was USSR, and the country needed the new design. When the first RBMK reactor, now called the RBMK 1000, was being constructed just outside Leningrad, on the Gulf of Finland, specialists were looking for possible locations for the first new nuclear power plant. They considered Ukraine, and quickly narrowed the options down to two. One of them was a site previously proposed for a fossil fuel power plant. The other, which was finally chosen, was an area of the sandy bank of the Pripyat River, near a small, postcard-like village of Kopachi, some 15 kilometers from the town of Chernobyl. Before Ukraine's first nuclear power plant was commissioned, the Leningrad station received the first RBMK reactor. It started up on December 21st, 1973, and December 22nd was the national holiday, the day of the power engineer. If you think that was a coincidence, it wasn't. This should tell you again how poor the design was if they had to meet the time quotas, not the quality ones. When the second unit of the Leningrad station was being built, the other two locations were already being prepared: Chernobyl and Kursk. But it didn't take long before the RBMK gave the first signs of being unreasonably dangerous. It hasn't even reached its full power when the flaws became apparent. Some quickly, some slowly, and others took much time to reveal themselves. The three main problems were the positive void coefficient, the size of the reactor, and the scram procedure, including the infamous AZ5 button. But that's the story for another episode. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me know in the comments if you'd like me to continue this subject in the next week. If yes, I would tell you more about the three mentioned problems that were the curse of the RBMK design. I hope you learned something new today, and you will watch the other videos on our Chernobyl Stories playlist. Take care. Stay safe, and see you next week.